Getting the height of the first layer of your 3D print perfect plays a huge part in whether or not the print will actually come out successful. So today, you'll learn what a good first layer looks like and how to achieve it. A printer pro reached out to me for this sponsored video series to be featured on their printer guide platform. Launching in January, it'll be home to 3D printing tips, tricks, and guides. Check out A Printer Pro and the printer guide site at the links in the video description below. Essentially, what you're trying to accomplish with a properly set nozzle height is good adhesion of your printed part to the print bed. There are a few other important bits to that, which we'll look at later, but let's first start out with a nozzle height, or more accurately, setting the correct zero position for the Z-axis. 3D printers don't have a way of sensing when the nozzle actually touches the build surface, but they rely on an Endstop or a separate sensor to probe the bed. For both cases, you usually need to manually set the zero position. The exact procedure differs from printer to printer, but the general idea is usually the same. Use a thin piece of paper for stiffer beds and a thicker piece, like a business card, for springy beds, and adjust the Endstop or sensor offset until you can feel a slight resistance from sliding the card around when the printer moves to the zero position for the Z-axis. Make sure the nozzle is clean and ideally heated up so that any boogers will get wiped away by the paper. Start in the center of the bed for a first rough adjustment, and if your printer does not have a sensor-based auto-tramming or auto-leveling feature, make your way around the bed and repeat for each adjustment point. Move the print head as close as possible to the adjusters and tweak them until you get an even resistance at each of them. The fine tuning to get the height perfect will need to happen with a few test prints. Of course, for this way of adjusting the nozzle height, you should be sure that your 3D printer is neither over extruding nor under extruding, as that will throw off the look of the layers. So start a simple print and watch the first layer being laid down. If there are visible gaps between the individual lines, you need to set the nozzle closer to the bed. If you can see the nozzle digging through previous lines and can't see each line clearly when you look at the bottom of the printed part, try setting the distance a bit higher. To check how well the entire surface of your print bed is aligned, check out the sample files linked in the video description. Some people recommend going for a bit of an over-squashed look, but I generally prefer the height set perfectly and then working with the following tricks to increase adhesion if necessary. First off, make sure the bed surface is in good working order. If you're printing onto bare glass or a specialized print surface like PEI, Biltec, or even unheated blue tape, give it a quick wipe down with some alcohol to remove any greasy spots. If you're using glue stick, Printafix, or another wipe-on or spray-on adhesive, you can usually freshen that up with a damp towel or by simply applying a fresh layer altogether. Also, use your slicer settings to increase the extrusion width and height for the first layer only. This will have the extruder pumping out proportionally more material, which not only really smooshes the plastic against the bed, but also makes the first layer more resistant to little adjustment errors. So with that, there's really no need to get the bed perfectly flat and bump-free down to the last 10 micrometers. Typically, you can go as far as 2 times the nozzle size for width and a full nozzle size for layer height, but this is pretty extreme and will likely overstress your extruder. To counteract, try going slower for the first layer only. This is also a good idea in general if you're struggling to get the first layer sticking well. Printing at a lower speed will give the filament more time to heat up inside the hot end, and also warm up the bed surface a bit with the radiated heat from the heater block, making it easier for the first layer to stick. To get a similar effect, try raising the temperature of the heated bed and the nozzle by 5 to 10 degrees Celsius just for that first layer. Many material and bed surface combinations will stick much better just with that extra bit of temperature. Keep in mind that many cheap heated beds will bow up or down as they heat and cool, so when using this tip, keep an eye out for the second layer as well and use a constant temperature for the heated bed if you see the second layer getting overstuffed or separating from the first one. Alright, so I hope this video is helpful to you. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing to the channel, and because YouTube is being sort of weird about it, remember to also click that bell next to the subscribe button, or you might end up missing some videos altogether. If you want to support this channel with a spare dollar or two, head over to Patreon and get access to monthly Q&A hangouts and more. That's it for today, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one!